So hello everyone, today we are going to provide one lecture on liposome drug delivery system, which is very popular as far as novel drug delivery system is concerned, as because this particular drug delivery system having several features which can be incorporated and utilized for getting better therapeutic effect of different kind of drugs. So let's start the introduction portion. In this session, we are going to cover few topics, and these are the content of my today's lecture. First, we'll cover the introduction part, which will in this part we'll just going to provide brief introduction about the liposomal drug delivery system. Next, we will going to discuss about the composition of liposome, its mechanism of formations, different factors which may influence the developments and all, advantages, disadvantages, some of the classifications, method of preparation, evaluation, applications, and marketed product which are presently available, as well as some clinical trial product which is going on. Now coming to the introduction part, if we just look towards the history of this delivery system, then it is quite distinguished that liposome was first discovered in the year 1965 by scientist Bingham. This is a Nobel bullet concept, and in this particular concept there are two different phases, like oil phase as well as water phase. Both the phases can be incorporated inside a single delivery system, which offers us some unique features for delivering the drug in a proper way. Now, as we have told that the term liposome itself derived from a Greek word, that lipo, and zomes mean the structure. So it's a combination of lipid with an proper vesicular structure. That's why it is known as liposome. Liposomes are in generally of spherical in shape and having an unique core material, which is made up of aqueous phases, and outside the material is made up of lipoidal material, which is basically of phospholipid and cholesterol. Liposomes are relatively smaller in size and maybe ranges between some micrometers to nanometer. So as a result of due to its very small sizes, it actually capture a huge areas as far as surface features point of view. It is going to absorb the drug and release the drug quite easily. Next, we'll move towards the composition of this particular drug delivery system. Basic composition consists of phospholipid and cholesterol. These are the major component of the drug delivery system, whereas phospholipid is a common component which is available in our biological membrane also. This is the most common components of biological membranes. Here we can find out, as per the structural point of view, this is the phospholipid molecule having an arrangement of polar head and non-polar tail. These are the non-polar tail portion, and this is the head portion. Head portion is generally aqueous in nature, as because it's a polar components, and tail portion, these are the hydrophobic matters, means these are lipophilic in nature. So as a result, it offers both the hydrophilic drug and lipophilic drug to get inside and interrupt. Now phospholipids are the combinations of hydrophobic tail consists of two fatty acid chain and 10 to 20 carbon atoms with an 0.6 double bond structure in each chain. Hydrophilic heads consist of a phosphoric acid and to bound water soluble components. These are the major molecular components of composition of liposome, which is consist of phospholipids. So from this structure only, it can be easily distinguished. Next, composition of liposome consists of cholesterol, which is going to play a vital role in the composition. Cholesterol do not have any role to form the bilayer. However, the bilayer is formed by the phospholipids, But cholesterol provides the optimum flexibility so that it can be readjust or form the network structure very smoothly. At the same time, it reduces the permeability of bilayer membrane in presence of biological fluid. We can see the structure of cholesterol and its applicability. This is simple phospholipid molecules, and these are the combination of cholesterol which creates some flexibility in this delivery system. So overall, the combination of phospholipid and cholesterol create the basic structure of liposomal molecule, and it provide the necessary flexibility in a certain extent. Now coming to the advantages part. Being a part of novel drug delivery system is obviously having a greater advantages over conventional drug molecules, and this particular liposomal drug delivery systems are mainly serve several purposes like targeting of particular tissues or organs or particular area where drug can be delivered. And along with that, it's having several advantages, like for example, suitable for the delivery of hydrophobic and hydrophilic both kind of drug. This is to be noted down. Hydrophobic drug as well as at the same time hydrophilic drug can be introduced inside the delivery system and can be dispensed. So it's a unique feature of this particular drug delivery system. Next, liposome increase the efficacy and therapeutic index of the drug. Means by using liposomal drug delivery system, we can actually improve the efficacy of the drug too. Means liposome increase the stability by encapsulations. It has been seen that whenever some drug with a higher concentration comes to the body fluid as well as tissues, may create some irritations. For those kind of drug, it can be easily given through this delivery system, which can establish the stability point of view as well as which can improve the release profile as well as interaction with the body components. Now another point, it can be suitably used for controlled release drug delivery systems, means the release rate of the drug from the dosage form can be controlled or can be sustained for a particular period of time. Suitable for the local actions as well as particular tissues. For example, number of cosmetic formulation nowadays available, which can be given topically and made up of liposomal drug delivery systems, concept of liposomal drug delivery systems. So that is another important area of this drug delivery systems. Suitable to administer via various route. As I have told you that it having very micro and nano range of particles, so as a result it can even given to the parenteral roots too, and at the same time for topical applications it is flexible enough to give the topical application point of view. Liposome help to reduce and exposure of sensitive tissues and toxic drugs. As I have told earlier, the sudden exposure of a few type of drug can produce some irritations or tissue damage, and at the same time that can improve the toxicity level of the drug. So to reduce those kind of toxicity as well as tissue sensitivity, this kind of encapsulated system are quite acceptable as compared to the conventional one. Now moving towards our next slide, that is disadvantages. Unlike other formulations, this particular type of formulations also having some limitations. These limitations are, once administered, liposome cannot be removed. It is, whenever we are just administering liposomal drug delivery system, basically we are talking about the systemic applications. So once it will be applied, we cannot remove the dosage form, as because it will already reach to the systemic circulation. So it will be quite difficult if any sort of sudden toxicity arise on the formulation. Next, yes, possibility of dose jumping. What happened actually, the vesicle is a major component of vesicle are biological membrane, means phospholipids, cholesterol and arm, which having quite similar with the biological membrane. Now it may happen that sudden condition that cell, the biological component outer layer can get rupture. If it happens, so suddenly there will be a chances of releasing high quantity of drug any particular area or site, tissue sites. So as a result, what it may leads to some extent toxicity as well as irritations. Leakage of the encapsulated drug during storage. It may happen as because they are temperature sensitive, liquid layer can get rupture, and suddenly amount of drug can release during the storage condition, as because for those kind of delivery system we have to maintain a proper storage condition. Like a conventional drug delivery system, if we store it in an open container or in an open environment, suddenly there will be changes in their bilayer configurations, and chances of leakage of active constituent from the process form may lead to a bad impact. Low solubility. Solubility as because once the process form is administered, suddenly as the outer layer is made up of lipids, so aqueous solubility of the drug will be, process form will be poor. And last but not the least, this production cost is high. To develop such kind of delivery system, we require a specific instrumentations as well as laboratory assembles, so that the production cost get increased. So next, the mechanism of formation of liposomes. Quite interesting area. Here we have to understand how liposome actually prepare and what are the steps involved during the preparations of liposome. First of all, whenever we are just try to mix that organic solvent systems along with phospholipid, cholesterol and other components, drug components together, and we just try to convert it into a liposomal form, few steps is arise. First of all, when the lipids matters get solubilized along with the cholesterol and drug molecule, they will create one sandwich structure due to their configuration. After certain processes, when it reaches to a particular shape and size, it will be orient themselves in this particular way. Hydrophilic head will be orient towards outside, and this is the hydrophilic head, which again will be orient towards the inside core, which is called aqueous core. Now in this picture you can find out this is the aqueous core, and this is the tail portions, which actually hydrophobic in nature, means lipophilic in nature, and this aqueous core is actually made up of polar component, surrounded by the polar component, so it is aqueous in nature or hydrophilic in nature. So whenever we are incorporating a hydrophilic drug, that hydrophilic drug will be incorporated inside the core, and whenever we are going to introduce any lipophilic or hydrophobic drug, then it will be kept inside this area. So overall, it is a bilayer of lipid as well as aqueous matters. In formation of liposome, several bilayer can be exist, like number of multi-level bilayers, single level bilayers. So as a result, it will create a unique dynamic system which reflect the proper efficacy of liposome. Next, classification of this liposome based on the different parameters, we can classify the liposomal drug delivery systems. Among the most important classification based on the structure of the parameters. Structure means it might be a multilamellar, large vesicle size, oligolamellar, small vesicle size, unilamellar, very small size, small unilamellar vesicle composed of a single lipid layer with a diameter ranging from 330 to 70 nanometer, medium unilamellar, these are comparatively bigger size than the small unilamellar size, so it will be ranges between 70 to 100 nanometer, 70 nanometer to 100 micrometer. So large unilamellar, they are above 100 micrometers, and number of other classification are there, they may be ranges between 1 micrometer to 100 micrometer. So based on their structure, it can be classified like that. Now, based on the method of preparations, It can also be classified. For example, single oligolamellar vesicles have made by the reverse phase evaporation method. Multilamellar vesicles, they are made by the phase evaporation method. Next one is stable fluid vesicles. They are also made with some of the direct method as well as indirect method. Freeze throwing methods are also there, and dehydration and rehydration is one of the important method which is by through which it can be prepared. Based on the composition and its application, several liposomes can be prepared based on their applicability. Like conventional liposome, it can be prepared using neutral or negative charges, phospholipid and cholesterol. pH-sensitive liposomes are there which can change their configuration as well as their activity based on the changes of pH. And then cationic base liposomes are there. Cationic lipid and in combination of dope, we can prepare it. Long circular liposomes systems are there. We can utilize this particular system for prolonged actions in the blood stream. And some of the liposomes can be utilized based on development of the immunity power or immunity booster. Now come to the method of preparation part. In the method of preparation part, physical dispersion method, solvent dispersion method, detergent solubilization method, these are the three main types through which we can prepare that particular drug delivery system. Now, physical dispersion method further can be classified into three types: handshaking, non-handshaking, and face drying method. Now, to reduce the size of that particular things, we can use some microemulsion method, membrane extrusion method, ultrasonications, and French cell methods. To increase the liposome size, we can utilize dried reconstitution vessels and freeze throwing techniques. Method of preparations based on solvent dispersion method. This solvent dispersion method can be further classified into several types, like ethanol injection method, ether injection method, water organic phase, means double emulsion method, reverse phase method, and stable polylaminar vesicles. So next we are going to discuss about the method of preparations. Different method of preparations can be utilized for preparation of liposomal drug delivery systems. Among these, most popular are physical dispersion methods, solvent dispersion methods, detergent stabilization, solubilization methods, and physical dispersion methods can be further classified into majority of three types, like handshaking methods, non-handshaking methods, and freeze-drying methods. Now, method of preparation of liposome by using some other aspects to reduce the liposome size. This is actually not method of preparation. It is actually we are maybe required of different size of liposomes. After preparations of basic liposome, we can reduce the size of the liposome up to a certain extent by utilizing this particular structure. For example, micro emulsification method, membrane extraction method, ultrasonications, French pressure cells. So these are the things can be utilized. And to increase the liposome size, we can further utilize two more steps, and dried reconstitution of vessels and freeze throwing techniques we can utilize for development of different structure and size. Method of preparations, in case of solvent dispersion method, they can further classify into ethanol injection method, ether injection methods, water organic phase methods, means double emulsion methods are there, reverse phase evaporation methods are there, and stable polylamellar vesicles formations are there. Detergent stabilization is one of the important methods under the solvent dispersion methods. So now we are just going to discuss a simple method which we in general can be utilized in the laboratories to prepare the liposomes. Here you can see that we have to take one round bottom flex where we can introduce our phospholipids, liposomes, phospholipid component, and organic solvent in a particular tissue. Then we have to shake the things and to make the cholesterol part dissolve. So next we are just going to utilize proper handshaking, and we can use rotary evaporator to evaporate the solvent systems. Once the solvent system is evaporated, we actually find a layer of that phospholipid and cholesterol over here, and then we can go for drying the film. And once the film is formed, then we have to dry it. The film once get dried, then we can hydrate by using either phosphate buffer or your aqueous solution for a certain period of times. Once the proper hydration is over, then you can find a vesicular system like that, and you can reconstruct the vesicular system for further for development of different size and shape. This is the overall preparation methods that can also utilize in our laboratory scale for development of such liposomal drug delivery systems. Now microemulsion techniques and other techniques what we were discussing at that time, or the membrane extrusion methods, as you can see, once the liposome get formed, the liposome dispersion system get formed, that liposome dispersion system can be filtered out by using some polycarbonate filter membranes. These filter membranes, once filtered out, the smaller size of the particles that will be extracted out in the liposomal contents. So by this particular method, we can actually modify the size and shape and factors, different structural factors of the prepared liposome. Now, bus sonication method or probe sonication method. Here, the particle size and formation of this vesicle can be reconstituted or by using some sonication systems, which will exactly create that uniform size of liposome for a tenure of time. And if we are using some cationic anionic system, then we can use some electrode system also for preparation of such kind of things. Now, these are some set of instrument which can be utilized for preparation of liposome, or for giving them the proper shape and size, or filtration technique can be utilized for reconstitution of the things. And the most popular method is known as ether injection or ethanol injection method. Here, ether or ethanol are utilized as a solvent system. That solvent system compound composed of the cholesterol and phospholipid part, and the cholesterol and phospholipid part are generally solubilized in these particular systems. In the lower part, where you can see this heated water bath is there, and the aqueous phase, these two are the aqueous phases where we have to pour the ethanolic component over here. As the heat is provided to the aqueous phase, it will be suddenly remove the alcoholic part or ethanolic part. Say the sudden removal of that particular part will create one vesicular form, and the drug which is to be interrupted will be interrupted as a vesicles in this particular area. Some of the evaluation, most important thing is the evaluation part. What are the different sort of evaluation we need to perform to find out whether your prepared formulation is up to the mark or not? First, physical properties like size and its distribution, surface charge, percentage capture, laminarities, and drug release. And chemical portion is phosphorylated concentration, cholesterol analysis, and stability analysis. These are the few things we have to evaluate after preparation of an liposomes. Now, applications. Application part means it can be applied in a different form for different disease and different systems, health oriented issues. For example, cancer chemotherapy. In case of cancer chemotherapy, it is largely used for loading the cancer anti-cancer drug and provide the anti-cancer drug to the particular area. Liposome as a carrier system. Carrier system for steroidal components and other components, body essential components, can be also given by this liposomal drug delivery system. Liposome, as it is compound of lipophilic materials, it can also utilize for topical applications also. Even in case of pulmonary drug delivery system in the form of aerosol or droplets, liposome can also be given or delivered to a particular area. So these are the overall applications of liposome. Above and all, number of research is going on, number of new delivery system and application of this fundamental principle of preparation of liposome are nowadays applied in some different other fields too. These are the few marketed products which is right now available in the market for treating different disorder like cancer therapy, lungs cancer and fungal infections, and these products are already in the market. These are the few products which are under the clinical trial stages, and right now the clinical trials are going on in phase 1, phase 2 and phase 3 in different aspects of developing such kind of formulation based on the liposomal drug delivery systems. So these are my references which I have followed to prepare this presentation. You can also follow these particular references for standard books like SP Bhaskar Kar and NKJN CVS publications for preparing your own notes on and another depth of knowledge. You can apply these particular references. So thank you very much for your kind listening. Now this particular topic what we have